Right, we've just turned the pump on. The old man's gonna try some. Just decided if anyone's gonna die, he's at the end of his life now. There you go. Let's have a go then. You can't tell at the camera angle. There's a bit of sediment in it.
Ah, there is much in it.
God, I tell you what.
That's
water. Actually tastes really good. Morning, folks. So this morning we are hopefully going to start drilling for some water. The folks at Aquasource dropped off some kit, and they'll be along with the rig shortly, I think, which is exciting. We've just spent the morning doing a bit of water divining with welding rods, which we've taken the outside shell off. And I didn't work so well for me. It does a little tiny bit, but not significantly. It turns out the old man's a magician, so it'll be interesting to see what the drilling folks say when they come back. But I suspect we'll end up drilling just down here. So an exciting afternoon ahead. We shall see how we get on. Do that again. What I'll try and do is capture how tight you hold them. You're gripping them really hard. And you just think about needing a really strong pee. And there you go. Look at that. Just a little bit. That's funny, isn't it? See, if I try and move him now, just stay still then. Does he eventually come all the way back? He does look. Try and go. I'll put it over there. You stay still.
I am staying still. It's coming back.
It is, isn't it? It's a funny thing, isn't it? God, look at that.
That's not the wind, either. Got on, mate, now.
Yeah. Look at that. Well, there you go, folks. If you need any water divining done, I've got some welding rods and an old man we can farm out for that purpose. Cool, look at that, that's good, isn't it?
There it is, there you go, right there. You went that mad there. Yeah, that was it. Well, that bit of being a wizard.
he's decided he doesn't want to be filmed being a wizard anymore. Well, I think we'll dig a hole there, shall we? What do you think?
Let's see what you think?
And then if there's no water down there, we'll put the old man in. We'll just put the old man in and put the top back on. And that'll be that. Funny old thing, divining for water. So a couple of chaps from Aquasource have turned up. Darren and James. And James here is just showing off with his divining skills. So now I'm going to record him. And you just know what's going to happen. It's not going to work, is it? Pressure's on now, James. Geez-o. It's the only pair of clothes I got. fact he only wants to go 40 metres. Eh? No, I mean, 40 is the typical depth, but they would go down to 60 if they, you know, they'll keep going until they hit water, if you know what I mean. And then if they haven't got anything by 60, I think they find somewhere else. I mean, is that like a, you know, is that typical? You get normally get more or less?
Quite a bit for back there.
Is it?
Quite often you can get the ground floor.
Yeah. Folks, it's a Thursday, it's mid-morning, it's finally stopped raining. I slept in this morning after what was a pretty big day yesterday, because the guys came and drilled the borehole, and it was just an exciting time, really. Never seen a borehole being dug before, and also it's a real kind of milestone for us, so a bit of stress beforehand, lots of stressy excitement during the day, went to bed knackered, slept in, it is what it is. But it was miserable anyway, so I didn't miss out anything. And yeah, bit of a summary I guess of it. I had no idea what kind of good flow rates are But the guys seemed to think it was between 30 and 40 gallons a minute, which in their words is a pretty good hole. I don't know how you describe a good borehole, but they said it was pretty good. And James, the guy who was kind of leading the crew, was really, really pleased with it and said that we wouldn't have any trouble with it. And actually the pump that goes in the bottom doesn't pump at 30 to 40 gallons a minute anyway, so we won't be able to draw that amount even if we wanted to. So, a success. I'll give you a quick overview of where we're at. The hole itself is capped with a little concrete cover. So, you can see this. That is where the white tube you'll have seen in the other footage is. And there's actually two holes, the other one for the electric cabling and the pump. The other riser will just sit in between. We're not expecting the guys to bring out the pump until potentially Monday, maybe tomorrow, maybe Monday. We've then got to run the pump for a couple hours every day, just to kind of flush the hole out a little bit. And then just test the water by sticking it in a glass and looking for residue, etc. And then there'll be a kind of pH test, etc. in time. So for a couple of weeks, it's kind of run the pump, test the water, run the pump, test the water. So that's for us to do. And anyway, the filtration units and tanks and all that stuff will go in the shed, which will be over there. And obviously there's no floor and there's no shed. So until the shed and the floor are in, we can't put a filtration unit in if we wanted to. The water that came out of the hole yesterday, by the time they'd put the pipe in, sorry, by the time they'd finished drilling to the depth they wanted to go to, the water was coming out pretty clear, and certainly clear enough for them just to use it to clean the drill and the piping in the hole, which is quite clever to watch. So they literally just take the drill bit off the bottom of the hole, spin the pipe work in the hole, the water pressure with the compressor pushing the air in cleans the piping, came out sparkling, and the water quality looked really good. So I'm really excited about that. The guy's view was that it probably wouldn't need a lot of sediment and debris filtration. I'm going to do that anyway because my OCD won't let me not do that, but it looked really clear. So I feel like we've got a really reliable, significant, clean water supply. Although it's a little bit hard to picture because at the minute it's just a little concrete box on the floor. But yeah, it's a really big milestone. And when the pump's in, even though it won't be filtered, I will be able to access it and use it around the site, which is another big milestone for us. So, as I say, lots of stressful excitement yesterday. But a big milestone nonetheless. The reason I'm just kind of stood meandering around the site this morning is that I'm half expecting the shed folks to turn up with the steelwork. And one thing I'm getting used to is this kind of idea of Devon faff, which is you phone someone, they say I'll get back to you, and they will eventually, but it's not quite with the same urgency that you get in other walks of life, really. So they may show up, they may not. If they don't, there's plenty of other things to be getting on with. I just hope it stays dry. So there we go. We have water in a little concrete box. And once we've got a pump, we'll be able to use it.